Hi, my name is Josh Oberwetter. I'm a director of engineering on the Amazon Relational Database Service, or RDS team. I joined AWS about 5 years ago to work on the sorts of infrastructure problems that I faced as an application developer earlier in my career. And so today I'm very excited to share with you a tool that we built to help customers manage and debug database performance problems. We're going to go through four topics. One is a quick introduction to RDS and Amazon Aurora, just to make sure that folks know what those things are. The second is a brief overview of how you can access RDS performance metrics today. Basically the tools that you can use to monitor your RDS databases. And third, I'll explain the additional problems that Amazon DevOps Guru for RDS solves. And lastly, I'll give a demo. All right. So let's start by talking about Amazon RDS. So Amazon RDS makes it simpler to set up, operate, and scale a relational database. Basically, this means that RDS automates the tasks like creating a new database and taking backups. Now let's jump on to the primary topic of this talk, which is database performance. There are several levels of monitoring in RDS. Database instance level, operating system level, and database engine level. And we're going to go through each of these in a little bit of detail now. So for instance level metrics such as CPU, memory utilization, and storage IOPS, you would use CloudWatch. If you're an AWS customer, you're definitely familiar with CloudWatch already. And one of the great features of CloudWatch is the ability to notify you when something bad happens, right? So there are CloudWatch alarms. It lets you send emails, SMS notifications, things like that. And I bring this up not because you're not familiar with that already, but because as you'll see later, DevOps Guru for RDS also supports notifications. And the performance anomalies that it detects should be less noisy compared to static alarm thresholds. And one of the goals of the product or project was to help reduce alert fatigue for your on-call engineers. So the next level is operating system metrics. Sometimes RDS customers need visibility into granular operating system metrics like swap activity, CPU and memory consumption at the process level, that kind of stuff. So for this purpose, we offer a feature of RDS called enhanced monitoring. And then the third level of observability is a feature of RDS that we call performance insights. So it's a fully managed feature. You don't have to install any additional software to use it. And it supports all Amazon RDS engines. The first topic I'll cover with performance insights is something that's very fundamental to the way we built Amazon DevOps Guru for RDS. And it's a synthetic metric that we call database load. So if you're familiar with Linux load, then you are also familiar with database load because conceptually it's supposed to capture the same information. It's basically an indication of how busy your database is relative to the total compute capacity on that database. So for example, in this graph here, we see a database instance with a maximum capacity or CPU of 2. And then you can see that sometimes the database load is higher than that. And that means that something's not able to make progress. Something's waiting, right? And as you'll see later, database load anomalies are really kind of the fundamental first step of DevOps Guru for RDS. In addition to database load, you can see a lot of other information, a lot of other metrics that we would collect from the database engine itself. For example, as you can see on the screen, what queries are using the most resources? The last thing I'll say about performance insights is that it's not just for experts. The purpose of this tool is to really try to help DevOps engineers, application developers, as well as database engineers or database administrators to diagnose database performance bottlenecks. All right, so now on to the main event here, DevOps Guru. So Amazon DevOps Guru launched in May 2021 with a goal of giving you a simpler way to measure and improve application operational performance and availability, basically reduce downtime. When DevOps Guru identifies an anomaly, it alerts you, just like CloudWatch alarms do. And but it also gives you additional information about likely causes so that you can prevent or resolve issues more quickly. And I think that's one of the key things to keep in mind about DevOps Guru and DevOps Guru for RDS. When you have an issue, a performance issue, time to resolution is extremely important. And so part of the goal of the product is to help you figure out what to do next. One of our goals within RDS is to make managing relational databases kind of accessible. We build domain expertise into the product and with a goal of making the product usable by generalists, not just by database experts. And so you'll see that as we walk through the demo, hopefully. DevOps Group for RDS, it builds on decades of experience that we have at Amazon running relational databases. And you know, we basically did a bunch of additional tuning of the DevOps Guru system for databases, not just of the anomaly detection system, but also to ensure that we can provide database specific recommendations that, you know, and best practices to help, again, to help you resolve issues as quickly as possible. So if you're anything like me, you like to understand how things work. So we're going to give a quick breakdown of this. So it starts with performance insights. That's where the raw metrics come from. On top of those metrics, we do anomaly detection. Again, I mentioned earlier that we did a bunch of database-specific tuning here. And but the goal is to help you find issues, unusual behavior. Once we find a potential issue, an anomaly, then we analyze what the database was busy doing during that time. And our goal here is to help you provide hints to you to help you resolve the issue more quickly. We then would notify you of this issue via the RDS console and some of the notification systems like that I mentioned earlier. And then ultimately that hopefully will help you understand and resolve the issue more quickly. Before we get into the demo, just to give a sense of what's possible, what types of issues might be detected, what we've been talking about so far are reactive insights. That refers to issues that are either have happened or are happening now. So things like database locking contention, CPU exhaustion on the database, or as I mentioned earlier, an increase in database load. There's actually a separate type of insight that the DevOps Guru for RDS produces. They're called proactive insights. It's things that might become issues soon, but I'm not going to give a demo of that today. All right, so here comes our demo. Okay, so now we're in the RDS console, and I'm going to go through two demos here. One is how you turn on DevOps Guru for RDS, and then the other is an example of an anomaly, so you can see how what the system does. So in the create database workflow, we'll create an Aurora database. And if you scroll down to the section about monitoring, right, this is a monitoring feature ultimately. So Performance Insights provides the inputs. So you need to turn that on for production databases. You know, we usually actually think that 1 month is the best option, but you also can use the 7-day free tier. And then you just leave this, you just check this box and turn it on. There's a little bit of nuance about what additional resources you want to cover with DevOps Guru. Remember that DevOps Guru does not just cover databases. And so, for example, you can turn on DevOps Guru for a CloudFormation stack. And this workflow uses tagging to ensure that you can turn it on for a single database at a time. So DevOps Guru is a free, has a free tier, which you can read about in the documentation. And once you exceed that free tier, this is the hourly price, which turns out to be about $3 per month per database. All right. And now if we jump back over to the databases, we will see that there's an anomaly. So the system found a problem. The reason we put it in this part of the console is that, you know, if you have a large fleet of databases and you just need to know which one to look at, then you know, this is supposed to help you figure out, oh, one of my databases is having a problem right now. So let's click on this and see what type of problem. We think it's a medium severity problem. So we determine the severity based on some heuristics. So for example, how far above the capacity is it? How big or how much of an anomaly is it? And we'll categorize this as low, medium, or high. And hopefully that will help you figure out, you know, how urgently you should look at this issue. You click on the link, and now we see the details of what's happening. So this is our database in question. We know it's an Aurora MySQL database. And this is a brief description of what the issue is. 12 times above normal, right? So a bunch of this, in fact, all of this information that you see on the screen here is also available in Performance Insights, right? Again, it's Performance Insights is the underlying data. But what's different here is that the system is telling you what to look at, right? And again, if you think about time to resolution, if a system can tell you where to look, then hopefully that will save you a bunch of time and you can resolve the underlying issue more quickly and get your application back up and running more quickly. So if I mouse over this, we can see that there are two wait states that are higher than usual, or contributing to the database load. One is client connections and the other is SQL handler. And I'll talk about those in a second when we scroll down, because the system explains what those mean to you, right? In case you don't know. But before I explain that, let me just briefly explain what a wait state is or a wait event is. So when a client connects to the database, it's going to ask the database to do something, for example, run a query. And while the client is waiting for that to finish, the database maintains a counter in the background. So if you're waiting for a lock, it will increment a locking counter. If you're waiting for I/O to happen, it will increment a locking counter. And so this is an indication of what your database is busy doing. It's a great place to kind of start debugging if you want to understand what your database is busy doing. Okay, so then we scroll down further and we see, okay, now we know a little bit more about what's really going on here. First thing is that it's doing a lot more reads. That's what this is. That's what this means. And we'll see that it'll be pretty obvious once we get down here why that's happening. There's a table scan, right, happening under the covers, right? And then the other thing that's happening is that the query volume has increased a lot as compared to normal. And if you click on these mouse overs, I guess, then you get kind of an additional level of detail about kind of what's happening now and how that compares to the normal behavior of your database. And then in addition, it tells you that basically your database is busy doing I/O. So database I/O, there are multiple types of I/O. It could be reading the data, it could be reading on the client connections. In this case, it's both. The application that I used to generate this anomaly is a Lambda function with no connection pooling. And so it's just, you know, every time it runs a query, it opens a connection, and that's creating a high level of churn there and a bunch of I/O. And then in addition, in parallel, there is a query here that, you know, is a select star from table, which is very expensive. It's causing the database to do a lot of I/O activity. And, you know, hopefully this information is enough to help you figure out what's going on, right? You should add a connection pool. You should figure out why this query is so expensive and why it's being run so many times more than usual. If you want to do your own investigation within Performance Insights, you can click through this link and that will take you back to the other, the RDS console. All right, so just to recap the presentation, we built this tool to empower everyone from database administrators to DevOps engineers and application developers to be able to you know, debug performance problems and to resolve them as quickly as possible. We think the tool helps you to detect, diagnose, and fix a wide variety of problems. It's available for three of our RDS database engines today: RDS for Postgres, Aurora for Postgres, and Aurora for MySQL. And you can get started in the RDS console just by enabling DevOps Groove for specific databases or for entire accounts. I'm going to share some additional resources, links to additional documentation that will help you get started. So thank you for your time. We would love to hear about how you're using Amazon DevOps Groove for RDS and how we can help you prevent or solve database performance issues.